should be reading this in bed. That was something
armed
nice.
Robbery in progress at the Oaks Scarp Lane.
Come on.
Repeat. Armed robbery in progress at the Oaks Scarp Lane. Sierra 1. Suspects on. Repeat. Suspects on. That is the Oaks Scarp Lane. Sierra 1. Sierra Oscar 85. Sierra Oscar 87. Give me an ETA. Over.
Sierra Oscar 85. ETA 4 minutes.
Is there any chance of a number for this Scarp Lane address?
Negative. Informant, a Mr. Garrod.
Sarge. Yeah, I think it's on a private
estate. I think it's got its own security round.
Come on!
Dave!
Kick your hair off.
Sierra Oscar to Sierra 1, can you give me your ETA? Sierra 1, ETA, 1 minute.
That's it.
Quinn.
Yeah, I think so.
Take the back with you, Dave.
Going to knock on the door now.
Give me a minute to get around the back.
What's going on, Dave?
What is going on at the moment, Mrs. Copley?
It was a wind-up,
yes,
sir.
I appreciate that.
A bunch of blokes taking bets on how long it would take us to get there.
You're joking.
All half-cut, of course, all-night party. I mean, Mr. Garrod made the call to.
Sir.
And is Garrod there?
We think so.
Someone to see you at the front desk, sir.
Right. I want Garrod nicked, and I want him back here.
Quinnan's dealing with it, sir.
Goodbye, Mrs. Copley.
Yeah, all right, sir.
Are you Mr. Garrod?
Yeah. Of course I am. Have a drink.
How am I? Garrod's the name.
A coincidence, isn't it?
Barry, got one on the main set, mate. Suspect's on, mate.
It's possible.
Good luck, Dave.
Thanks. I am Carl.
Dave.
Oh, look, it's Big Ears.
Just shut it, OK?
You tell him, Nubby.
Dave, I'll sort it out, OK?
Police brutality.
Mr. Garrod, did you report an armed robbery in progress on these premises?
What do you think, Noddy?
I'm arresting you for making a hoax call to the emergency services. You're not obliged to say anything, but anything you do say may be...
Rewritten and fabricated as usual.
May be written down and used in...
Fabricated. A bit of a long word for you, isn't it?
Stand up, please, Mr. Garrod.
Stick it where your brains are, big boy.
Steve, stand up!
You get off me!
Dave?
Sorry to keep you waiting, Mr. Lodge. I'm Inspector Monroe. What can I do for you?
It's more a case of what I could do for you. I've got something interesting outside my cafe, haven't I?
What precisely?
Ah, well, that's the point, isn't it? What's it worth? Well, let's see the colour of your money first.
You're a bunch of zombies, aren't you?
Oh, look at
that. There are staring eyes with nothing behind them.
Shut it!
Come on, in you get. Come on. Get your head down. Come
on, move, fellas.
Yeah!
I'll take
Get your hands off me.
Yeah!
I'm making a phone call. Are you supposed to let me, you badger?
It's a supervised call and it's...
When I say so.
Rubbish. Pathetic. Nothing better to do than to nick someone for having a laugh.
I'm getting sick of you. Shut it.
Steve, see the boys.
I've told you, Mr. Lodge, I'm not in a position to register informants on a Sunday, and I'm not in the habit of being blackmailed either.
Well, that's nuts, isn't it? I'll come in here to help you out, and you won't pull a stroke in return.
It's your duty as a citizen to report a crime if you think one is being committed. Any reward will be considered afterwards.
But why should I?
I thought I'd just explain that, Mr. Lodge.
You must think I've fallen out of a Christmas cracker.
I'll see you out, Mr. Lodge. And by the way, withholding information is a criminal offence too.
What about my phone call?
Just sign, please.
And I want a doctor to look at this.
I don't mean your bent filth doctor either, I mean my doctor.
Shut it.
It's about the extent of your vocabulary, isn't it? Shut it. No wonder you keep banging people's heads into things.
Philip Allen Garrod.
Cheers, Kev.
He slipped the net so many times, he must be son of Houdini. Tosh reckons he's got his hand in half the bent deals in Sunhill. The minute you dig up something suspect in the property or construction business, up pops one of Garrod's companies in the background.
Now he decides to wind us up. He's got some front, hasn't he? Yeah, listen, George.
Garrod's always there, but always out of reach. You name it, he's got a company doing it.
And doing it bent. How comes he's never been nicked?
Oh, he's been nicked. But only for settling his arguments with a piece of two before. Mm. There was evidence for that, but this, he's always wriggled off.
What do you reckon, George?
I reckon Munro wants to see you.
What happened?
Garrod's only trying to bring a case of assault against me.
What did Munro say?
Harder, he'd give me his full support, the usual rubbish.
Wasn't he pissed off?
Huh? Why should he be? Garrod was resisting arrest. He stumbled and fell. End of story.
The court might not see it that way.
Thanks. I mean, I don't believe this. He decides to take the mick and then he wants to prosecute us for arresting him.
Prosecute you?
The whole thing's crazy.
Yeah, but it's evidence, isn't it? Kath Marshall said we never had enough evidence to nick Garrod on, didn't she?
George.
But in your case, the evidence came leaking out of Garrod's head in front of six witnesses.
You're such a comfort, George.
Right, it's a Mrs. Copley first. Noise complaint, St. Stephen's Gardens.
Is it really?
Don't worry, Mrs. Thomas. I'm sure he'll come back when he's hungry.
Kathy, busy morning.
Been fairly quiet here. I hear you had a bit of excitement there.
That's what I wanted to talk to you about, actually. Our practical jokers.
Oh, yeah.
I understand you know something about Mr. Garrod.
Well, only what Tosh told me. And I pulled his card out for Dave Quinnan just now.
Yes, he's the reason I'm asking. Garrod is planning to bring a private prosecution for assault against Quinnan.
Oh, that's ridiculous.
That's what I told Garrod's solicitor when he tried to coerce me into dropping the charges against his client.
In what?
He wanted to come to some arrangement. Call it quits.
Cheeky.
Yes. I'd like as much info on him as possible, Kathy, when you have a moment. Garrod's got the makings of an uncomfortably good case of assault against Quinnan, and I'd like to have all the ammunition I can in case it comes to it.
Such as?
Well, Garrod's got a history of violence, hasn't he? That'll do for a start. I'm not having an officer like Quinnan get himself in trouble over a piece of slime like Garrod.
Yes, Mrs. Copley, I'm sure an officer will be there any minute.
Is that noise complaint again?
Yeah, it's the third time this morning. The noise stopped 7 hours ago.
Funny, I'd have expected Quinnan to be there by now.
I'm not lying if they call us up.
I'm not asking you to. We're on our way to our next call, aren't we?
No.
Look, it's legit. They've been drinking. The cars are parked outside. Stairs to... We're in business. I reckon that's our lucky winner for this morning. Get the number.
Yeah, I've got it. Golf 452, Yankee Lima.
Damn. They're waiting for the A11, aren't they?
Foxtrot? Foxtrot.
Where are you going?
I'm cutting off.
God, Dave.
Lost him.
Good. Let's get on with what we're supposed to be doing, shall we?
The trouble with you, George, is you don't like sticking your neck out.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Sticking our noses in what villains do is supposed to be our job, not something to be avoided just because somebody's made a complaint against us.
Looks more like a personal vendetta from where I'm sitting.
There. There, look.
What are you doing now?
going to take a closer look.
What about the drink driving? What about calling in the BMW, eh?
You call it in.
Sierra Oscar from 218, receiving, over. Well, Sherlock, we've lost him.
Yeah, I know.
It's probably just as well. The car belongs to a Stephen Owen, and it's legit.
Has Owen got any form?
Didn't ask, Dave. I didn't ask because any minute now, Alec Peters is going to come out here and personally kick us all the way at Mrs. Copley's house.
No plates.
Doesn't have plates, Dave. The tractor unit that pulls it carries the plates.
Yeah, I know. And the excavator doesn't carry plates because it's not a road vehicle.
So what?
So? How do we know who it belongs to? What if it's been nicked? It's being looked over by mates of a known criminal.
Dave, what are you doing? Dave? What about Mrs. Copley, Dave?
She'll have to wait. Look, it's been resprayed. I reckon the engine number's probably been ground out and all. We're calling it in, Georgie boy.
Yeah, 218, go ahead.
Sergeant Peters would like to know your position, George.
Yeah, we're at the transport calf, June. Dave's still checking over the excavator.
I think Sergeant
Come on,
Peters
Dave.
Would like a word with Dave, George.
That block hasn't had its number ground out, and I'm Frank Bruno.
Are you receiving, George?
Oi!
Sierra Oscar from 340.
What exactly are you doing at this transport calf, Quinnan?
It's got no markings. It's got no engine number that I can find.
And it's being inspected by associates of a known criminal, Garrett.
What were you doing following them, Quinnan?
When you got a moment, Alec.
Between drive, that's all. The serial number on this excavator is just a screw-on plate. Well, that's a piece of cake, isn't it?
Hold on a minute, Quinnan. Yes, sir?
What's Quinnan up to?
Reckons he's found a dodgy earth mover, sir, in a transport cafe car park. Seems he was following these...
What did you say?
A transport cafe car park.
Let me speak to him.
340 from Sierra Oscar.
340, go ahead, sir.
This transport cafe you're at, Quinnan. What's the name of it?
The Star Diner, sir.
Right, Quinnan. Get yourselves and the Panda out of sight. Repeat, get out of sight and keep your eyes on that earth mover. That fellow Lodge tried to sell me some information this morning.
Sir?
About something outside his transport calf, the Star Diner. See if you can find out where Lodge lives, Alec, and get him to open up for us. Yes, June?
Owen's got form, sir. Theft, handy.
Owen?
Yeah, the owner of the car that Quinnan followed to the car park.
Yeah, Quinnan followed some of our practical jokers from this morning, sir. Looking for a drink drive, I think.
I see. But he turned up this. And so he could have a chance of nailing one of Garrett's cronies at the very least.
That's right, sir.
I'll speak to Quinnan later.
I've got Lodge, sir. 134A Bedford Avenue. Minor traffic and a fare dodging in 1987.
I think I'll deal with our friendly cafe owner personally. Good morning, Mr. Lodge. I'd like a word, please. Yes,
well,
I know they're open.
I'm sure the insurance company would consider a reward, Mr. Lodge. Given my recommendation, of course. It's going to be best if you walk the rest of the way, Mr. Lodge. You should find one of my officers in hiding somewhere.
Eh?
Oh, don't worry. He'll make himself known to you.
Oh.
Plant machinery reported stolen at all this weekend, let alone something with the serial number Dave Quinnan gave us.
We can't link that number to an owner, can we?
How? DVLC don't keep details of excavators. If it can't be driven on a road, then it doesn't have a number plate. And if it doesn't have a number plate...
It's not on the DVLC computer.
Yeah, it's crazy. Our only hope is that someone notices it's been nicked from the site.
On a Sunday?
Precisely.
340.
Yeah, go ahead, Dave.
So what right do we have to stop someone driving this thing off then, June?
We're working on it, Dave.
Is Lodge a walking dustbin with the brain of a cuttlefish?
Hello?
Affirmative.
Anybody there?
I think he's just arrived.
Owen's house is empty, sir. Not a sign of him.
Right. I'll be in my office if you need me, Alec.
Sierra, ask him from 340.
Yeah, go ahead, Dave.
Yeah, I'm in position, June.
If that's the right word for it.
Where are you?
Don't ask.
Here, I found a few more. Come on, pull your finger out.
Don't push your luck, chum.
About blasted time.
Oh, it's Mrs. Copley, is it?
Yes.
Yeah, can I come in for a moment, please?
No, I don't want you in here. I want you over there. That's where the noise comes from. Three times in the past 6 weeks at God knows what hour of the night. Music and the bang, bang, bang of some infernal machine. Get over there and sort them out.
Yeah, well, strictly speaking, madam, it is a matter for the environmental health officer.
Yeah, I've had a thought. What about Jeff Birch? He does plant hire and his garden centre's open on a Sunday. He might have a bit of info.
Two good ideas in one day. He'll be applying for sergeant next.
Now, the keys are always left on them, so coat of paint, change the serial numbers, and Bob's your uncle. Somebody's lost 65 grand's worth of machinery.
Yeah, but where do they go?
In the auction sometimes, but usually it's straight on the ferry with a dodgy T-form. Oh, David, put these out for me, would you? No, I've lost an eight-wheel tipper myself, 35 grand. Why can't they just put some sort of coded lock on them or an alarm? You wouldn't leave a 65 grand roller line around like that, would you?
No. Well, thanks, Mr. Birch. You've been very helpful.
It's all right. Ah, cheerio.
Yeah, see ya.
Oh! How big did you say it was?
Well, I didn't, but it's massive.
More than 10'6" wide.
Yeah, I should say so.
Well, then it's a notifiable load, isn't it? You have to inform your traffic boys where you're moving it from, too, don't you? And the ferry company. Happy hunting.
Thanks.
Sierra Oscar from 218, receiving. Over.
Yeah, that's what the racket was.
A compressor?
Yeah, spraying paint, most likely.
2 o'clock in the morning, you say? Mm. Do you know whose yard it is?
Yeah, some flash git in a BMW.
Oh, yeah.
So, this yard belongs to Owen.
That's right, sir. And June Atkins tracked down a ferry booking this evening at Dover for a load that size to be pulled by a tractor unit registered to one of Owen's companies.
So he's allegedly painting something at night and he's moving a load to Dover.
Yeah.
Hmm. Well, provided he's got the right documents.
Which he will have.
We can't do a thing.
Yeah, well, I suppose we could...
See you in court, chum.
I look forward to it, Mr. Garrod.
Well, we could look for its original markings.
Not without blowing the observation.
That's right. Someone could report it stolen.
Unlikely before tomorrow.
Sarge?
Yeah?
Oh. Index number Delta 364 Lima Romeo Delta. He's backing it up now.
That's the unit booked on the ferry.
Can we get a soccer over there now?
I'll try it. Check his documents, Dave. Hold him for anything you can.
Mate?
Yeah?
Sunhill Police, would you mind showing me the documentation for this vehicle and its load, please?
What do you want to see it for?
I have reason to believe it may be stolen property.
Rubbish.
Get one unit over there to watch the load and one to bring Quinnan in with this driver.
Right. 340 from Sierra Oscar. On what charge, sir?
340, go ahead.
Sir?
Well?
I'm arresting you on suspicion of handling stolen property. You're not
obliged... On what evidence?
But anything you do say may be given in evidence.
Right, what evidence? Take it easy.
The engine number on this vehicle is missing.
What engine number?
Come in. Ah, Quinnan. When I told you this morning that I give you my full support against any allegations Phil Garrod might be making, I don't recall suggesting you go and hang around outside his house like a spiteful child. Is my memory correct?
With all due respect, sir, I felt there was a...
Yes or no, Quinnan?
Yes, sir. Sorry, sir.
Now, that's that sorted. Now, rightly or wrongly, that was a good piece of work today, Quinnan. And if I had my way, sticking your neck out would be written into the Met's code of conduct.
Well, thank you, sir.
Let's see what this driver has to tell us now, shall we?
Well, thanks for letting me stay on, sir.
You're the investigating officer, Quinnan, and that's why you stay on.
Yeah, well, I appreciate it, sir. Thanks.
Sir, Hollis has had a bright idea for once in his life. Now, this Copley woman lives next door to Owen's yard, so she must have been upstairs in her bedroom that time of night. Perhaps she saw something.
Well, surely Hollis would have asked her that already. Now, where is he?
2:05, he'd have gone by now.
Well, what about Detra and Loxton?
Well, thank you, Quinnan. We'll get them to pay Mrs. Copley another visit.
That excavator's no more bent than I am.
Well, let's hope so. For the sake of your liberty, Mr. Evangelisti.
What about the engine number?
I've told you. I didn't even know they had one. I mean, do they? Do you know?
See, I haven't a clue what they was doing in
no,
there.
No, you can't.
But there was all manner of comings and goings. Heaven knows what sort
yeah,
of dangerous
right, look,
things
did
they
you
mu-
see any vehicles entering the yard before you went to bed, Mrs. Copley?
No, not at bedtime. But a big digger went in at tea time. I remember that because, you
what,
see, I had
was
to go
there any
my-
name on it?
Oh, yes. My name, or my initials, Pamela Gwyneth.
PGC.
Phil Garrard Construction. What? He's only had it away with one of his mace machines, hasn't he?
Can the Socco confirm this?
Well, it's got as far as a P and what could be a G. But it has to be, doesn't it? And the witness is 100% certain, too, that her initials.
So, Mr. Evangelisti, in the absence of a bill of sale, we shall be charging you with being an accessory to the theft of this machine from Phil Garrard Construction. What have you got to say for yourself now?
Look, I've done nothing. I'm just a driver for Steve Owen.
So why go down for him then?
I'm not.
I'm afraid you are.
Look, how about if I tell you the truth?
It would certainly put you in a much better position.
Okay.
So, who stole this machine from Phil Garrard Construction?
Something funny.
That's the point. It's not from, it's for.
Eh?
Owen nicked it for Phil Garrard, didn't he? Double bubble. The cash from flogging it and the insurance money to boot. Get it?
Double bubble.